Thank you, everyone. Our imagery of occupation is steeped in a traditional vocational roles, such as a doctor, a nurse, a teacher, an electrician, and the list goes on. It is influenced by the social context in which we interact, most notably from our parents and wider family networks. For me, life as a researcher was a foreign concept. And to this day, I still explain to people that I'm not just a uni student, and there's actually real work stuff that goes on behind the scenes of the university, in the lecture theatres and the classes. And yes, they now do pay me to do what I do. So currently, I'm a research fellow within the Social Epidemiology and Evaluation Research Group in the School of Population Health. Before I elaborate further on where I am now, we will travel back a little bit and have a short reflection on my journey to date. Thinking back, I was one of those children that drove a mother nuts. So inquisitive, always needing to search for new ideas, and very imaginative in my creative play. So were you also the child that kept asking why? To me, the asking why is one of the many fundamental questions to being a researcher, along with the who, when, what and how, but asking why is part of the development of a critical thinking skills, something that builds the foundation to any research methodology. At high school, I knew I wanted to keep studying, but the choice of degree was something that I had not a concrete idea on. My favourite subjects were physical education, learning languages and a little bit of science. So the answer I came up with at the time was a Bachelor of Health Sciences at the University of Adelaide. It left me to think and consider all the things that you do in your early 20s. Although it still left the people the questions of, but what do you want to be? Again, vocation was driving a need for people to understand what I was actually doing and not just wasting the years away. The degree, though, gave you a taste of the core subjects of human biology, pathology, and a requirement to undertake public health. On the side, you could choose subjects from arts and social sciences and the sciences in general. So as far as I was concerned, that was a good mix for a degree to keep me busy for the next 3 years. I then followed it up with an honours degree in public health, and you'll notice that I change around a little bit over the years, but at the time I was looking at the surveillance of malaria cases in South Australia. And then after the year, I was left with, then what? Life after undergraduate studies was definitely a stage of crossroads. It was during this period that I worked in what was then the Department of Human Services. I worked for the Cancer Council of South Australia, and the Central Northern Health Service, and I was picking up what I could, when I could, in terms of jobs after university. I worked in numerous areas of population health, including injury prevention, cancer control, population health surveillance surveys, and a cohort study in the area of chronic disease epidemiology. It was at this stage that I made a shift in disciplines and turned back to the books and for study. I had the opportunity to work on a large Australian Research Council linkage project to undertake a PhD in the Faculty of Social Sciences at the University of Adelaide. This research saw me to undertake a PhD in geography and gain an interest in the places in which people live and how this influences our health. Undergraduate training in public health had given me an insight into the stories of the cholera epidemic in the 1840s in London. And as this picture up on the side here shows of the story of John Snow and the Broad Street Pump, classic public health, where the environments in which people live, that is the water supply of the Londoners, were influenced the rate of cholera. The interest in place within the discipline of geography is not only the only aspect to being a researcher. Research also will take you places, as in the words of Dr. Seuss, all the places you will go, to conduct fieldwork, to collaborate, and to present your research findings. Here I've indicated research as action, doing things. So on the left-hand side, I'm filling up the car with some surveys of a couple of hundred that we were doing into the Murray-Mallee region. It also involves complex thinking on the logistics an undertaking of research design, and I kind of like a whiteboard a lot. And when I left that job, they actually gave me a whiteboard, so if that says anything. And finally, there's also the important points of with the team. This is stopping off at the Mount Mary pub on the way home, so that's also an important part of research. Research in place also means an opportunity to work in a different context. And within our research team, we have collaborations among a number of areas, but to name a few, India, France, United States, and Canada. I have been fortunate this year to undertake a 3-month fellowship from the Australian Academy of Science in New Delhi, India. 2 weeks ago, I returned, and so fresh in my mind is the incredible experience of working with our Indian colleagues. I had the opportunity to undertake field work within the villages of the Powwow district in Haryana state, and it's an area about 80 kilometres south of New Delhi. And the area is undergoing land zone changes and rapid economic and social change. To be able to explore the changes in the environment alongside changes in health behaviours and outcomes is made possible through the surveillance of aspects of the built environment, such as roads, buildings and agricultural land. And this is also alongside the capture of health and social information on all 51 villages, and it equates to about 200,000 persons in the area. It was an amazing experience to undertake fieldwork in a country like India. Here are some pictures of me and my clipboard undertaking some fieldwork and meeting some young girls in the village. At the same time, I also got to see some pretty amazing places like the Taj Mahal, and it certainly is a wonder of the world. Okay, so doing research also allows you to develop cross-cultural relations. Whether it's your own visit to a faraway place, or contact via Skype or email, or students and fellows that visit Adelaide to conduct research with our team. I've been on a few visits to wine regions to show our visitors around some of our local produce as well. And here I've shown an example of some Canada in Australia cross-cultural relations. And this was a chocolate tasting competition, a blinded study of chocolate sampled from both Canada and Australia, ranking the best tasting by brand, and an overall country allegiance score was factored into this. Of course, we do everything in moderation because we are public health people. I've also had the opportunity to develop lifelong friends through my studies and research. And it just happens that you end up hanging around people that you kind of like, and they have similar interests with to you as well. Okay, I've been in the last 2 years the president of the South Australian branch of the Public Health Association. And this role has allowed me to get interested in a diverse set of population health issues in terms of advocacy and with social justice at the heart of what we do as organisations. And we're linked in with the other four major organisations in public health as well. But at the same time, you get to meet pretty amazing public health practitioners and researchers. And my personal favourite is the Honourable Basil Hetzel, who this lecture theatre is named after. So I had to stick a picture of me and him up there. Today I truly can say that I am an interdisciplinary researcher from the different research training that I've had in undergraduate and postgraduate studies, crossing methodological paradigms, but it also allows me to think about such a variety of issues, to be busy and inquisitive, and keep on asking the burning question of why. Being a researcher is a job that allows you to have self-autonomy, and being a researcher allows you to meet some of the most amazing people and see a diversity of places. Remember always, though, to be passionate about what you do and believe that you are making a difference. Pick up on your strengths, and you could be somebody that's working with people and community members, participants, policymakers, getting in the inner geek with databases and bias statistics, or you could do both as a mixed methods researcher. And finally, most importantly, surround yourself with people that are good and have fun while you're doing it. So good luck on your journey. Thank you.